We're asked to factor each expression by factoring out the greatest common factor. The greatest common factor of an expression would be a term that contains the most number of common factors among all the terms. So to factor 2x plus 8, we want to find the greatest common factor of 2x and 8, and then write this as a product. One way to identify the greatest common factor would be to write all of the terms out in prime factored form. So we can write 2x as 2 times x plus, and now for the prime factorization of 8, well, 8 is equal to 4 times 2, or 2 is prime, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So the prime factorization of 8 would be 2 times 2 times 2. So we have plus 2 times 2 times 2. And now we can see the common factors between these two terms. Notice how the only common factor is 2, which is the reason why 2 is the greatest common factor. So now we're going to factor 2 out of both of these terms. So if we factor 2 out, we're going to have 2 times the quantity, whatever factors are left when we factor the 2 out. If we factor 2 out of 2x, we're left with the x, plus if we factor 2 out of 8, we're left with 2 times 2, which is 4. So the factored form of 2x plus 8 is 2 times the quantity x plus 4. Once we factor, we can always check by multiplying. Notice how here if we distribute 2, we're going to have 2 times x, which is 2x, and then plus 2 times 4, which is 8, which means this is factored correctly. Next we have 12x minus 15. So our goal here is to find the greatest common factor of 12x and 15. If we're able to look at these two terms and recognize the greatest common factor is 3, we can go ahead and write it in factored form in the next step. But if we're not able to, it's always best to look at the prime factorization of both terms. So for the prime factorization of 12, 12 is equal to 4 times 3, and 3 is prime. 4 is equal to 2 times 2, which are both prime, which means you can write 12x as 2 times 2 times 3 times x. And then we have minus, well, the prime factorization of 15 is just 3 times 5. Both are prime. So we have minus 3 times 5. And again, the nice thing about writing this out in prime factored form is that we can actually see the common factors. In this case, the only common factor is 3, so 3 is the greatest common factor. So we're going to write this as a product by factoring out 3. If we factor out 3 from 12x, notice how we're left with 2 times 2 times x, which is 4x, and then have minus. When we factor 3 out of 15, we're left with 5. So in factored form, we have 3 times the quantity, 4x minus 5. If we distribute, we would have 3 times 4x, which is 12x, minus 3 times 5, which is 15. So again, we do have this factored correctly. Next we have 16y minus 24. If we can look at this binomial and recognize the greatest common factor is going to be 8, we can go ahead and just factor out the 8 in the next step. But let's go ahead and show our work by writing out 16y and 24 in prime factored form. So 16 is equal to 4 times 4. 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So the prime factored form of 16 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which means you can write 16y as 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times y. Then we have minus the prime factorization of 24. We start with, let's say, 4 times 6. 4 is equal to 2 times 2. 6 is equal to 2 times 3. So the prime factorization of 24 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. So we'd write this as minus 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And now we want to circle all the common factors between 16y and 24. Notice how there are 1, 2, 3 2's in common, which means 2 times 2 times 2, or 8, is the greatest common factor between 16y and 24. So because 8 is the greatest common factor, we're going to factor 8 out of our binomial expression. So we'll have 8 times whatever's left when we factor 8 out of 16y and 24. Well, we can see whatever we didn't circle is going to be the remaining factors. So here if we factor out 8 from 16y, we're left with 2 times y, or 2y. minus, if we factor 8 out of 24, notice how we're left with one factor of 3, so we just have minus 3. So this is the factored form of 16y minus 24. We have 8 times the quantity, 2y minus 3. And again, distributing to check our work, 8 times 2y is 16y, and then we have minus 8 times 3, which would give us 24. I hope you found this helpful.